Hey there, Benjamin from LoveStarter here, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Google Optimize using Google Tag Manager. And I'm also going to show you how to link Google Optimize to the latest version of Google Analytics, Google Analytics 4 or GA4 for short. Okay, so we're looking at the Optimize page on Google's marketing platform site. So we can click the button to get started, or we can simply navigate to optimize.google.com. Since I'm already logged into my Google account, we can see that we're ready to get started. And let's begin by creating an account. We need to name our account. I recommend using something similar to the name you've used for your Google Analytics and Google Tag Manager accounts. I'm going to name my account LoveStarter. You can choose the data sharing options for your Google Optimize account. And then you'll need to select your country. Agree to the terms, and click Next at the top. Now we need to name our container. You can set up one or more containers in your Google Optimize account. If you're just looking to run tests on one website, then you'll only need to set this up once. But if your organization has multiple websites and you want to run different tests on each site, then you can create a separate container for each site. This is just like how containers work in Google Tag Manager. Okay, I'm going to enter LoveStarter as the name of my container, but you can name this anything you like. Now let's click Create. Our new account and container has now been created. Let's click Settings. At the top we can see the ID for our Google Optimize container. We will need this in a moment when we head to Google Tag Manager, so let's copy the container ID. Now we can see the option to link Google Optimize to Google Analytics, so let's click Link to Analytics. You will see a list of the Google Analytics properties that you have access to based on the Google account you've used for Google Optimize. You can see Google Analytics 4 properties are highlighted with a GA4 label. And Universal Analytics properties, so the previous version of Google Analytics, include the property ID, which starts with a UA and a dash. So you can connect Google Optimize to GA4 or Universal Analytics. I just want to highlight that you can only link to one property, so I recommend selecting the one you use most often for reporting and analysis. I'm going to select my GA4 demo property from the list. Then we need to select a data stream. This should be the data stream that you're using on your website to send data to your GA4 property. For my GA4 property, we can see there's only one data stream, but if you have multiple data streams, take a moment to ensure you select the correct one. And if you're new to Google Analytics 4, then check out my other tutorials. I've included links in the description below this video. I also want to highlight that when you use a GA4 property with Google Optimize, there are some different limits. Let's head to Google Support article to take a look. Scrolling down, we can see that there will be different limits in Google Optimize when we connect to Google Analytics 4. Currently, if you want to target people coming from your Google Ads campaigns, this option is only available at the moment with Universal Analytics. We can run 10 experiments at the same time with GA4, while it's 24 if we're using Universal Analytics. We can choose from purchases, revenue, page views, and conversions for our experiment objective with GA4, while Universal Analytics includes some additional options, like session duration, bounces, and AdSense metrics. There are also some other differences. I've included a link in the description below this video so you can check them out. Okay, let's head back to Google Optimize. We've already selected our Google Analytics property and stream, so let's click Link. We can now see we've successfully linked Google Optimize and Google Analytics. And I want to mention that if you're not going to use Google Tag Manager to implement Google Optimize on your website, then you can add the snippet to your website to get up and running. And to create experiments and experiences in Google Optimize, you'll need to be using Chrome as your browser, and you'll also need to install the Google Optimize extension. It's straightforward, so I'll let you complete those steps yourself. And you can see I've already installed the extension. Okay, so we've already copied the container ID from Google Optimize, so now let's head to Google Tag Manager. Now we need to create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Optimize. And let's select Tag Configuration. And choose Google Optimize as the tag type. Now we need to paste the container ID we copied from Google Optimize. Next, we need to add a trigger, so let's select Triggering. And let's select All Pages. This will mean Google Optimize is added to all of the pages on our website. And let's save the tag. Now let's click Preview. Check that our website's URL is entered correctly, and click Connect. We can see Tag Assistant has loaded, and we can select the Tag Assistant tab. This shows us that the Google Optimize tag has successfully fired on our website. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. And let's click Submit to publish the Google Optimize tag to our website. Since we're using Google Tag Manager to implement Google Optimize, you might also want to add Google's anti-flicker snippet to your website. This is an extra piece of code that ensures that the page isn't loaded before the experiment. If the page loads first, then you might see the original content before your variant is loaded, and this can cause a flicker. Adding the anti-flicker snippet prevents this from happening, but it can't be installed using Google Tag Manager. Let's take a look at Google's support article. I recommend you read through the details. Then, scrolling down, you'll find the anti-flicker script. You'll need to modify this to include the container ID from Google Tag Manager. And if you've implemented a data layer on your website, then make sure the anti-flicker script is added after your data layer. Let's copy the script. And let's head to my website. We can see this is where I've added the Google Tag Manager container to my website. Now we paste the anti-flicker script above the Google Tag Manager container and replace the container ID placeholder in the anti-flicker script with the container ID from Google Tag Manager. Now we can save the changes. Now that we've added the anti-flicker script and we've published the Google Optimize tag in Google Tag Manager, we can begin creating experiments and personalizing the content on our website. Let's head to Google Optimize to take a look. Let's close the container settings. And let's create our first experience in Google Optimize. Today I'm going to show you how to create a simple A/B test on your website, but I've included extra links in the description below this video if you'd like to learn more about Google Optimize. Okay, let's name the experience My First Test. And let's enter the page we want to use for our test. Now let's ensure A/B test is selected. And click Create. Now we need to click Add Variant. We need to name the variant. This should briefly describe what changes you're making for your test. I'm going to name mine New Heading. And let's click Done. Now we need to click Edit. The editor loads. And we can now make the changes we want to test. I'm going to select the heading and click Edit Element, and then Edit Text. And change the heading so that it says Featured Products. And the color of the font. Once you're happy with your changes, you should take time to preview them to ensure they don't impact anything on your website. And when you're happy, click Save. And then Done. The next thing we need to do is define the objective for our experiment. So let's look for objectives. And then click Add Experiment Objective. You can then choose the objective. For this experiment, I'm going to select a conversion as my primary objective. You can also set two additional objectives for your experiment, but I'm going to leave these. When you're ready to launch your experiment, click Start. We've now linked GA4 to Google Optimize, implemented Google Optimize using Google Tag Manager, and launched our first experiment. What are you going to experiment with on your website? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.